In this video, I'm going to show you how I created this design, Viva Mexico, all in Canva for free using Canva components. I'm going to show you the tips and tricks that I've used to do this so that you can make something similar for yourself on Canva. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and I wanna share my experiences with you. I created this design, Viva Mexico, and shared it on social media, and a lot of you wanted to learn how to make it. I made it in Canva for free, and I'm gonna show you how I did that, some of the tips and tricks that go along with doing something like this as well. And all of this can be done for free. There's lots of different places that you can do graphics and find graphics for t-shirt designs or print-on-demand designs if you're doing that. Canva is a great resource. I'm going to show you exactly how I do it. You can follow along step by step and then use these tips to do something similar, do something that fits your style. You can do it with lots of different graphics. I'm going to use the graphics in this video, but of course there's thousands, millions of graphics on there that you can use some of these same techniques on and create something totally different. You can create a lot of things that are totally different. So hopefully stay to the end of this video, see how it comes out, and use these tips and tricks that I'm going to share with you. Let's get into Canva right now. All right, so here we are on canva.com. You can see I'm just canva.com. I'm using the free account. You can see right here. All you need to do if you don't have this or if you've never used Canva before, just sign up. It just takes an email and that's it. It doesn't charge your account or anything. This is totally free, which is amazing that all of this is for free. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is go to here, create a design, and go to custom size. I like to make mine 4,500 by 5,400 for a t-shirt. If you're gonna do print on demand, this is the size that you want. You want it at least 4,500 wide. You can make it bigger if you want, but that's what I'm gonna use right here. And click it, and you can see nice artboard right here. This is the size you're gonna wanna fill, okay? So first things first, the best thing to do on Canva is to find a good graphic on Canva. And there's a lot of good ones on there. And when you find them, I would heart them, star them, whatever it is. I think it's a star, actually. We'll find it right now. So first we go and find one. This one that I found, it was hard to find. I'm going to show you how to find it. It's Sombrero. I was looking up different Cinco de Mayo stuff. So Sombrero, like that. Type it in. You can see there's a ton of sombreros. Go to graphics right there. And you wouldn't have known this, and I didn't know this, but as I scroll down, you can see a lot of these are for pro actually too. So if you want the pro account, you can make so many more stuff with the pro account. Go ahead and do that. It's really good if you're planning on making a lot of designs like I do. I honestly probably should get a pro account as many designs as I've made. But anyway, let's go down here and see this right here. Look at that graphic. Isn't that cool? It's so cool. So I clicked on this and you can see, let's do a black background. So click on the artboard and then click on the color and then do black. You can see it's kind of got this neon kind of colors, right? Which is pretty cool. So let's go in here and then CC all. So click on see all right here and look at all of these. So cool. I kind of found this by accident, but then I made a design with it. So I don't want the circle. You could use the circle, and I think it would be really cool. One of the techniques that I'm going to show you is to use the crop tool. So the easy way to do the crop tool, let's say we want to crop this one. We're going to double click and do this, lift it up. Now, if I was going to crop this, I would crop this out like that and do it, and then you know, maybe make a copy, double click it and do the bottom part. Wouldn't this be cool? I just thought of this now, but crop out the bottom part like that, something like that, you know, and then put something in the middle. You can put, you know, Viva Mexico here in the middle or something like that. That would be a cool way to do it. But what I did in mine that I showed online is I did one of these. I think it was this one. Yeah, was this one. And I just made it the full size right there. I think it was that one. Let's see, what else is there? There's that one. There's so many of these, I can't remember. This one, I believe I put this one at the bottom. So let's put that there. And Let's see. No, it was this one. You could use either one, but look at all these. They're so cool. So I used this one. Yeah. But this one would work as well. So let's remove that one. Let's put this one at the top here, full length. Perfect. So we're halfway there. Got this. So the next thing I did was I needed these dots to continue to go down like that. Guess what I did? I went down here, scrolled this, double clicked on it, and cropped it. Just cropped the dots, right? And up like this. So now all you have are these dots. So you can put the dots right here, like a continuation of it, and then do another one. You know, this one, whoops, let me move this out. Double click on it, and then pull this down. So you only need a few more dots on the bottom. Let's do that, I think, right there. Look at that. Now I got my border to go all the way down. And it doesn't have to be a full thing. We could put this here like that and move this over here. Cool, now we got that frame. Let's see what else we can put in here. Let's put in Viva Mexico first. So let's do a type. Just click T on here, the letter T, and you're gonna see there's this paragraph, this text, T for text. That's an easy way to remember it. And then just type in Viva first. And we're gonna use the font called Rye, R-Y-E. I talked about it in my other video. It's a great font for Cinco de Mayo. So you can see I've used it before right here, Rye, or you could just type in Rye here. And you can do upper lowercase, but I did mine, the one that I did was all uppercase. So hit caps lock, Viva, or you could have just done this upper lowercase thing. All right, and Viva and Mexico, let's do like that. And we can stretch these across the bottom. Mexico, Viva, like that. All right, so the next thing we gotta do is kind of fill this white space. And what could we do there? So let's look on here for other things that we can add. So I believe I added one of these down here. Let's see, probably this one. Let's click that and make it bigger. Yeah, you see those maracas on there? Let's double click this and kind of isolate that part. So you can see what I'm doing is I'm just using that part. Double click out and make it bigger. And we can double click again if you wanna take out some of that right there. I think that works. And maybe even go up, let's see. Nope. Let's see how that works. Hey, that's not bad. So we'll fit that right there. And then another trick to do is copy this and flip it. So go here, flip, flip horizontal, and you know, kind of make it go out like that. Make this one come out here, and Viva. Now we can do the same thing with other things in here. Let's say we want to put this right here in there. So we can just double click on it and then come in and just isolate that part. So that little flower that we want, then click out, move. We'll move this over here like that and then move this back here. And again, we can do the same thing. Do this, hold down option and drag, and it's the same one here. So one last thing that you can do here to kind of just make this, put it all together, is I'm gonna move this up just so we can fill in the space. So move this up like that. And we can move this guy up, but what we'll need to do is change this. So double click on here, you know, maybe up to the 3 right there. And do the same on the other side. Double click and up to 3 right there. And let's see if that helps. Oh, we could probably just do 2. Okay, sorry. Do it again, up to 2 right there. Same, see? This cropping tool really helps. Whoops, don't size it. You wanna double click on it and then move it. All right, so now we move this up and then make sure this is sized correctly. So we move that till there, move this like that, and we can still move this guy here and this guy here and kind of size it to make it work. So like that, there we go, put that up there. Okay, and since this is white and there's no other white in the design, we can come in here and maybe change some of these things to white. So let's see what it looks like if we change some colors to white. So you can see I can check any of these colors. If I change this one to white, let's look at it. No, I don't like that. Then you can hit undo with Command Z, come back, click this color, click that. No, that's too much. I just want a little bit of white. So undo, maybe this color here. Yeah, that's not bad. That's those dots. Let's see. Undo, let's try the other light blue. Oh, that's too much. Last one, let's see if this one is a good. Yeah, I like that one. So you can see I changed that color to white and there's some white on that. Let's see if I can change some of this to white. So same thing, I'm gonna go in here, maybe check that dark color to white. Yeah, that could work. Let's do undo and then check all the colors. No, I don't like that one. That one's not bad. Maybe that one to white. Let's see this last one. Oh no, I don't like that one. So maybe this one to white, just to give it a little white. And then we can make this white as well. So this color was this right here. Make that white. And of course, you don't have to make it white. You can do whatever color you want. Pick different colors if you want. You can change the color entirely. In fact, if you want to change all of it, let's do this. I think this color is great, by the way, but if you want to change all the colors, one of the things I like to do is go to Styles, hit Colors. This one, that's weird, but it does change all the colors. So you can see some of these colors aren't the best, but it's fun to try and see if there's a color that works. Probably not as good as that. So there you go, that's my design. I'm gonna put Viva in the front just so it blocks out some of this stuff. Move that to the front. And there you go. Nice Viva Mexico design that I shared online in my social media posts. You can do any of these other ones. Remember in the elements, just go and pick any of these other ones to block it out. Use that crop tool, that's a real nice time saver. And then when you are in here, you can change the color. So whatever color you want, pick that, you can make it totally different. Doing it this way by mixing and matching all of this stuff, you make it your own style, so nobody will have this. It's very different, and of course you can use a different font. I used Rye here, you can use other fonts, and you can even change the color of the font. Maybe you want this the same color as that. Real easy to do, right? You come in here and pick that color to kind of match it. So, and you can make these, if you didn't know, you can make each of these a different color. So if you want to come in here and go and change it kind of more of a, you know, different color, maybe this one is white, maybe something like that. That kind of gives it a fun feel, right, to use all the colors in here. So have fun with this. Lots of different ways that you can do this and make it your own, of course, by using the different things here. And Canva is just such a cool thing to do. So thanks so much for watching this video. Hopefully it was really helpful and gave you some ideas on how to do your own Viva Mexico or Cinco de Mayo design. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. If this video was helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps in the algorithm. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button so that you can see some of my latest videos, know when they're out. Make sure to hit that notification bell to remind you. And if this video was something that you'd want to share, make sure to share it with your friends and family and whoever you think would be interested in this video. The question of the day for this video is not design related. I got thinking of Mexican food with Viva Mexico. So what is your favorite Mexican food? It can be anything, could be Latino food too if you don't have a specific Mexican food. Leave those in the comments. I love a lot of different things. I love those birria tacos where you can put it in the sauce and things like that. It's really good. So leave your favorite and hopefully we get to eat some of those soon. Thanks so much for watching again. And if you want to see more videos on how to do stuff on Canva, make sure to click these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.